Topic that we are going to start with our UGC NET is our teaching aptitude. So, अगर हम teaching aptitude की बात करते हैं, तो teaching होता क्या है? Teaching, if you talk about teaching, teaching and learning are basically the two sides of a coin. We know that every coin has two sides, and in case of teaching, you cannot teach, you know, you need, it is teaching and learning. That means the major things that we require is a teacher and a student. So it is the most acceptable criteria, and measuring for good teacher is the amount of students learning it. So how can you know that he or she is a good teacher? So it totally depends on the amount of students learning that thing. And this is also, we can say, in a highly correlation with the student's rating of the amount learned in the course and overall rating of the teacher and the course. So it, how many students have learned this and what they have learned and number of students, these are all in correlation with the teaching aptitude or the teacher, basically, I can say. So if it is a good teacher, the students will learn more that course, or they will be more interested, or they will be a good learner, I can say. So this is a correlation between them. So they are the two sides of one coin. So first of all, the question arises because after giving your UGC, we all will be becoming teachers, or the lecturers, or the professor, they're also teachers, right? So what is teaching? Teaching is basically a process of attaining to people's need, experiences, feelings, and making specific interventions to help them learn particular things. So I can say that, okay, teacher mainly वो होता है जो आपको अपनी life में guide करता है, आपको अपने experience से आपकी ज़रूरतों को पूरा करता है, और आपको time and again बताता है क्या सही है या क्या गलत है, और कैसे करना चाहिए. So basically, as it has been mentioned here, it is a process of attending to the people's need. What do they want? What is to be given to them in terms of education? Experience totally depends on teacher's experience, what to give, how to give. The feelings are equally important because we are all human beings. Specific interventions, basically what are you looking for, some specific thing or not, and how can you learn those particular things. So these all things are a part of your teaching. What can be the nature of teaching? Teaching, it's not only about that we learn in a school or a university, but teaching is one process that never stops. We all are learning. I mean, even a good teacher can be a good learner because she or he learns everything at that point of time. So basically, teaching, we can say, teaching is a process that facilitates learning, means it encourages learning, and it can be at different levels, it can be at different places, different situations. Anything that you learn is teaching. We say that in Hindi, there is a very popular saying ki zindagi hamesha logon ko kuch na kuch sikhati hai. So sikhana is teach, you know. So it is teaching you at different points of time. So teaching is, we can say, is a specialized application of knowledge, skills and attributes designed to provide unique services to meet the educational needs of the individual and of the society. We know that everyone wants to attain good level or good opportunities in their life. So they are, they want to have their knowledge, increase their knowledge. So teaching is the specialized application of the knowledge or the skills we have or the skills they want to learn with the attributes that are designed to provide them good education in the society or to the individual. That is also a nature of a teaching. Teachers employ practices that develop positive self-concept in the students. So teachers, they are the guides. They try to develop the positive attitude or the positive concepts of the students. Although the work of the teachers typically take place in the classroom settings, the direct interaction between the teacher and the student is the single most important element of the teaching. So in case of teaching, it is a, we can say, one-to-one interaction, direct interaction between a teacher and a student. Then let's talk about the characteristics of teaching. What are the characteristics? How can we define a teaching? Teaching should be dynamic, social and human. So dynamic means energetic. It's not that, you know, if you go to a class and let's say aap ek class mein jaate hain aur aap dekhte hain ki aapka teacher jo hai wo low on energy hai, energy nahi hai, personality wise acha nahi hai, to kya aapka man karega us teacher se padhne ke liye, ya aapka kya utna attention hoga us teacher ke liye? No, obviously not. So the dynamics of teaching is also important. Important that why you have gone there or what kind of attitude the person is carrying. Social and human means a teacher should be social, means easily good enough to mix up with the students and to make it a kind of a bit a friendly environment, because sometimes we don't learn the things with a rod, but we learn it with a love or a loving feeling or loving touch. So a teacher, the teaching has to be very social, related to society and other things. It has to be very humane. Humane means related to human beings. So that means teaching is influenced by humans and the social factors. So this is what I talked about in this point. Teaching can be an art and a science. So art in the sense, like art is how you describe yourself, like painting is an art, your dramatics is an art. So sometimes, like if you are, though you are teaching some scientific terms, but you try to explain them in a different manner or a different way, not like a bookish language, we call it as an art. Or if you talk about the science, yes, it is a scientific terms, so it has to be a science. Like I think aap logon ne wo film dekhi hogi, Three Idiots, which is the biggest example of this. There Amir Khan says that, you know, teaching ko aisa hona chahiye jo ki aapko easily samajh aa sake, wo aapke related hona chahiye. So like when teacher says what is a book or what is a zip, he gives a complete definition. When he gives a definition which is very simpler, teacher say, no, it is not good. Then he gives a scientific definition which was really tough for people to understand. So sometimes, depending on the conditions, it has to be an art or it has to be a science. So we can say that exercise of being systematic, and it includes talents and creativity. Talent of the teacher or the creativity, how they describe it, how they teach that subject, it totally depends, it totally differs. Next is like, it is like diversion. We have the diverse in applications. What kind of applications or what kind of technologies or what kind of methods we can use for teaching, that is equally important. टीचर का मेन काम होता है अपनी बात सामने वाले को समझाना. उसके लिए वो कुछ भी कर सकता है, कुछ भी इन द सेंस डिफरेंट टेक्निक्स यूज़ कर सकता है. अगर उसे लगता है कि अगर मैं लेसन से पढ़ा रहा हूँ, टीचर को स्टूडेंट को समझ नहीं आ रहा है, तो उस केस में वो ऑडियो विजुअल एड्स ले सकता है, वो कंप्यूटर से कुछ दिखा सकता है, या वो अलग अलग और डिफरेंट टेक्निक्स जैसे रोल प्लेस हो गए वो यूज़ कर सकता है. सो दे हैव टू यूज़ डिफरेंट एप्लीकेशंस टू टीच अ स्टूडेंट. मेन मोटिव ऑफ द टीचर हैज़ टू डिलीवर हिमसेल्फ और हर सेल्फ टू द स्टूडेंट्स. So the objectives of teaching, what are the objectives? First of all, it is an all-round development of a learner. The main or the prime objective of teaching is the all-round development of the learner, which includes his physical, mental, spiritual and moral development. And this is on the basis of the Gandhian idea of education. Basically, this is what Mahatma Gandhi wanted. So all-round development in the sense, it's not a student should be only concerned about the, you know, mugging up the things and all that, but it should be a mental development, not a mugging up of the things. Uska dimag tez hona chahiye, reasoning power improve honi chahiye. He should have a physical development, means it's not he should be sitting at one point of time at one place only and no physical exercise. Or it should also develop moral, you know, the spirits and the moral values in the students. What is right, what is wrong, what they should do, what they should not do. So these all things should be developed here. Then the second can be like the behavior changes. What kind of behavioral changes are there? The education should be imparted to learn in such a way that it reflects the attitude, behavior, and personality of the learner. There can be many people, many students who are good learners, but they don't have good behavior, they don't have good attitude. Attitude in the sense, a positive attitude. You should have a positive attitude basically towards everyone in the, I mean, let's say there is a boy who is a highly learner, highly qualified, but his attitude towards the other people is not good. Maybe he doesn't have a good attitude towards the woman, for example. He considers them to be a second grade people of the society. So that is not a good attitude. So that behavior change has to be there in terms of teaching. So this is also one of the objective. Then he should have a good behavior. Maybe if he is talking to his juniors or subordinates or someone else, he should have a good attitude, behavior with them, and a good personality, of course, because what we see is what is sold. Agar aap bahut padhe likhe hain aur aapne aapki personality achhi nahi hai, you don't look good, so no one will look at you again. So personality of a learner is also improved in terms of your teaching. So this is the objective of teaching. Then another one is learner's mental ability. Teachers should take into account the mental ability of the pupil while teaching. This means, like, we all the fingers in our hands are not equal. So obviously the mental ability of the learner or the pupil is not the same when we have for everyone. So this is teacher's responsibility to check out the mental level of the or mental ability of the student, and then teacher has to design the teaching methodology or the teaching pattern according to the learner's ability. So this will enable basically a teacher to make himself more communicative with the student, and turn the students will be a better understanding of what they have been taught. So अगर आपको टीचर स्टूडेंट का, अपनी क्लास के स्टूडेंट्स का लेवल पता है, तो आप जानते हैं कि उसको किस तरह से डील करना है, उसको किस तरह से पढ़ाना है, किस तरह से उन्हें समझ में आएगा. सो दैट लर्नर्स मेंटल एबिलिटी इज इक्वली इम्पॉर्टेंट. देन द नेक्स्ट वी हैव इज ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ नॉलेज. ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ नॉलेज मीन्स आप अपने किस तरीके से, किस मेथड से अपने आप को, अपने टॉपिक को, अपने सब्जेक्ट को सामने वाले तक पहुंचाते हैं. दैट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, नॉट ओनली द सब्जेक्ट बट द नॉलेज ऑल्सो. कोई बात आपके पेरेंट्स अगर आपको सिखा रहे हैं, तो वो किस तरीके से सिखाया जा रहा है, वो नॉलेज आप तक किस तरह से आ रही है, दैट इज़ इक्वली इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो द प्रोसेस ऑफ टीचिंग शुड इंश्योर दैट द नॉलेज इज़ ट्रांसमिटेड फ्रॉम द टीचर टू द स्टूडेंट. And for this objective, the teacher needs to be very communicative, and the process of teaching should ensure the people participation in it. अगर आप पढ़ा रहे हैं, for example, एक teacher है, वो बोले जा रही है, lecture दे जा रहा है, और students हैं, they are not listening to them, सो रहे हैं, गप्पे मार रहे हैं, so obviously it is not a proper transition. वो जो आपका transition है या आपका जो transfer of knowledge है, वो हो नहीं रहा, there is not a smooth movement to it. So in that case, teacher has to be very communicative, और वो तभी हो सकता है when a teacher can ask a student to, you know, to interact, to participate in what he or she is teaching. And that can be done by different ways, like asking questions or their suggestions or their examples, something related to the topic. Then it is the friendly environment. One of the primary objective of the teaching is to make the environment of the place of teaching more friendly and conducive for the learning. That means the atmosphere of the class should be that the students should be very friendly. And friendly doesn't mean that, you know, you should go and say, oh, hi, what's up, teacher, and something like that. But friendly in the sense, the environment should be good enough for learning and of the things. So teacher can be a good friend also. It's not that teachers cannot be a good friends. The way they teach, how they communicate their things is equally important. But the teacher's attention, his or her attention, should remain focused to the teaching, and he should get irritated with the non-conductive atmosphere of the classroom. So if a student or the students are not learning or misbehaving, the teacher should be patient enough, should be focused enough on teaching. It should not that, you know, get disturbed or irritated by that kind of the non-conductive atmosphere in the class. Usually we get these kind of environment in some universities or sometimes in some colleges also. Some, I do not say all, but yes, some. So maybe where you have studied, that would be a different kind of an environment. The subject or the topic is also one of the main concerns. It differs what subject they are learning. So the subject and the way of learning, the way of teaching or the learning process is also important. So maybe there is a topic which you like, you will be pay a lot of attention in that class. But sometimes, you know, if you find, oh, this topic is so boring, I don't want to study this. So in that case, again, the attention of the class or that continuity breaks down. So in that case, the subject is the main concern of the whole endeavor of the teaching and the learning process. The topic is generally decided by the teacher, but the learner can also contribute in deciding a topic. So there is a balance and a harmonious development which takes place in that place. So if we talk about what do we require, what are the basic requirements of teaching? So first, the major requirement is the teacher. Obviously, we need a teacher to teach. And then we have is the learner, the one who's going to learn, the subject or the topic they are going to teach, and the environment. So these are the four major requirements of the teachings. So teacher is an innovator of information and knowledge. He is the creator and the transmitter of the knowledge, values and ethos to our youngsters for their physical, mental, emotional, and social development. So basically, teacher is an innovator who innovates different things. He innovates the information and the knowledge. And then it's not only that, you know, let's say if the teacher is there, he is keeping it everything to himself or herself. It is transmitting it to his, you know, students, to his disciples, we can say. So teacher is the one who transmits the knowledge, not only the knowledge, but we have the values or your ethos which are there. And that is all basically done for your physical or mental, emotional, and social development. That is an overall development of the students. Now the learner. The learner is a dependent one and immature. So teacher is a guide, you know. The driving seat is taken by the teacher, and the students, they are the travelers. So they are the dependents and they are immature. They have to cooperate in the teaching learning process with the teacher and try to get much information and knowledge from him or her. So basically, teacher is just like, we can say, a big sea of knowledge. So sometimes, you know, some students are like, okay, fine, whatever is given to us is okay. But some students or some learners, you know, they want to dig, you know, what is there in the sea. They want to take out everything. So they must try to get as much information and knowledge as much as possible from the teacher. Then we have as a subject or the topic. That is one of the main concerns of the whole teaching and the learning process. So if, as we said that, you know, if there is a topic which is not liked by the students or so in that case, it is going to hamper the harmony in the class, create an imbalance in the development, complete participation of the students is there. So mainly the topic is decided by the teacher, but learners also contribute in deciding the topics sometimes, so that there is a balance and harmonious development which takes place in the class. Next is the environment. The learner's growth and all-round development is the main objective of the teaching. So it is possibly only when there is a suitable environment for the teaching learning process. So that means, along with the other things, other basic requirements like the teacher, the learner, the subjects, environment is equally important. If we have a good environment, like healthy environment, where they are open for discussions, they are open for feedbacks and everything, then there is a good possibility of development out there.